The world's oceans hold many secrets. Only a small part of it has been explored, so there's still a lot to discover. Whatever fearsome creatures we encounter there today, they can hardly be compared to the terrible monsters that inhabited the ocean in the distant past. From the largest sharks to the ancestors of sperm whales that weighed 100 tons, to a fish with a vicious bite, this episode is going to show you these ancient monsters and tell you how they fought hundreds of millions of years ago. The Mosasaurus, or Mosaic River Lizard, lived millions of years ago. In fact, it lived 66 million years ago. They were as numerous as whales and sharks are today. They had colossal bodies. They had two pairs of flippers and long jaws with massive conical teeth. They could reach lengths of 10 to 17 meters and weigh an average of 115 tons. The Mosasaurus had a crocodile-like head and was similarly armed with hundreds of razor-sharp teeth. These helped the Mosasaurus take out even the most defensive of foes. By the time the Mosasaurus appeared, a very different creature was swimming in the world's waters. This shark is over 250 million years old, and at the time, the giant Ginsu shark, or Cretoxyrhina, was the largest and fiercest of all. It's Mosasaurus's main rival. Mosasaurus and Ginsu sharks probably hunted in the same waters. What could that have led to? Well, they were at war with each other. According to paleontologists, sharks attacked mosasaurs because some skeletons show shark bite marks. So, large sharks could have injured many mosasaurs. Sharks most often attacked young, injured, or sick animals, as well as cubs. The Cretoxyrhina was pretty similar to a modern great white shark. It was about 8 meters long and could weigh up to 3.5 tons. As you've probably already realized, the Cretoxyrhina was also an apex predator in its ecosystem. It preyed on a wide variety of marine animals, including mosasaurs and plesiosaurs, other sharks, and smaller fish. What was really scary was its teeth and jaws. They were key in battles with other aquatic creatures, and they bit with real force. Plesiosaurs were marine lizards that ranged in length from 2 to 15 meters. They lived from the end of the Triassic period to the end of the Cretaceous. There were two suborders of plesiosaurs, and their lifestyles were slightly different. One had a long neck and a small head, while the other had large heads on short necks. If you see a picture of a giant lizard with a long neck, many people might even confuse it with the Loch Ness Monster. What about the enemies of the plesiosaur? In general, the main enemy of the plesiosaur was the previously mentioned mosasaur. Short-necked plesiosaurs were faster, so they chased fish. Long-necked sea lizards were more intelligent. They used their necks to their advantage. They attacked in a way that caught the fish off guard, giving them no time to swim away. Mosasaurs were pretty strong creatures, though. They learned how to beat both their opponents. For instance, they'd go for the most vulnerable part of a long-necked plesiosaur. In a fight, a mosasaur would grab its opponent by the neck and literally gnaw on it. Generally speaking, plesiosaurs were into fish and cephalopod mollusks. But according to some reports, a 6-meter-long skeleton found inside a preserved mosasaur showed that plesiosaurs ate mosasaurs. So, the U-shaped jaws meant the ancient lizard could swallow its prey whole. This means it could have been a mosasaur sometimes. Liopleurodon was a reptile with a crocodile head, two pairs of flippers, and a short tail. Pretty unusual, right? Scientists still can't agree on the size of Liopleurodon. Some say it was about 6 meters long, others say it was about 15 meters. And in fact, the reptile is a representative of the plesiosaur family. Liopleurodon was one of the most fearsome predators that lived in the seas during the Jurassic period, about 160-155 million years ago. It was a true hunter. Its long jaws and powerful rows of sharp teeth made other competitors vulnerable in a fight. Let's imagine a hypothetical situation. Two of the biggest and strongest monsters in the world are fighting each other. Yes, a megalodon and a liopleurodon. What do you think would happen? First, you can study the sizes of the monsters. Then, you can get a better idea of who would come out victorious. Many scientists believe that the average size of liopleurodon was between 5 and 7 meters. So it's not huge. But the largest predatory shark in Earth's history reached 18 meters in length. That's about the height of a 5- or 6-story house. Megalodon is much bigger than the white shark, the most dangerous modern predatory fish. And what about Megalodon's 5 rows of massive, saw-like teeth? Megalodon teeth were about twice as big and strong as white shark teeth. They were between 10 and 13 centimeters long. Some Megalodon teeth reached 17 to 18 centimeters in length, and the largest specimen found was about 19 centimeters. So if any creature had decided to engage in combat, it would have been unlikely to survive. Size and sharp teeth are exactly the kind of advantages that would have given the megalodon an unqualified victory. Lyviatan Melvillei is a member of a genus of ancient sperm whales that lived in South America about 12 million years ago. It was discovered only in 2008. The unusual name of the genus comes from the biblical sea monster, and the name of the species from the name of Herman Melville, the author of the novel Moby Dick. We estimate that the total body length of the Leviathan was between 13.5 and 17.5 meters, and its weight was between 100 and 120 tons. The Leviathan had very large teeth. The upper teeth were about 12 centimeters in diameter and up to 36 centimeters long. These are the largest teeth of any animal in the world. This jaw was deadly. Both the megalodon and the Leviathan swam in the ocean about 10 million years ago. There's no record of them ever fighting, but let's imagine they did. What would have happened? Well, they were both predators, so they were both after the same food source, whales. At the time, there were a lot of them in the ocean. Lyviatan Melvillei and megalodon are similar, except that the whale would have been bigger and had bigger teeth, and the shark would have been more agile. In a fight like this one, the one with the better strike, and most importantly, the one who can spot their opponent first, is likely to win. Have you ever heard of Dunkleosteus? This monster lived between 415 and 360 million years ago in the late Devonian. It was one of the most ferocious creatures of its time. Just look at what it looked like. Dunkleosteus had one of the most powerful bites of its time. That means he could have been stronger than any dinosaur or any predator we know today. If you compare the modern crocodile, which has the most powerful jaws in existence today, to Dunkleosteus, which is twice as strong, the crocodile loses out. Individuals have been known to reach up to 8 meters in length and weigh about 4 tons. Dunkleosteus was probably the top predator of the time. Nobody could hunt it, so who was it fighting? Another Dunkleosteus, but of course smaller. Just picture this, two predators, each with bone plates that served as armor and weapons. In battle, the strongest and most cunning would win. All the creatures I've told you about really existed and swam in the world's oceans. But what about the mythical sea monsters? Let's take a look at them too. Watch this. And finally, I'll tell you about three creepy sea monsters that, fortunately for us, only existed in myths and legends. The Kraken is a legendary sea monster. It's huge. Its shape is like a giant squid or octopus. Legend says it lives off the coasts of Norway and Greenland. Its tentacles are strong enough to pull underwater ships and destroy cities. The Kraken is known for its endurance and strength. On top of that, it has a wide-open jaw with a mouth full of sharp teeth. Jormungand is a sea serpent from Scandinavian mythology. He's a symbol of darkness and destruction. This beast was spawned by the giantess Angerbodai from the god Loki. Jormungand was thrown into the ocean at birth. He grew up in the ocean, so big that he could wrap his body several times around Midgard. Midgard is a world inhabited by humans in Scandinavian mythology. There's a Japanese spirit called Umibozu who's said to live in the ocean and overturn ships if anyone dares to speak to him. The name Umibozu means sea and monk. Umibozu is believed to have a large round head, similar to the shaved head of a Buddhist monk. In addition, Umibozu is described as a demonic ghost that causes shipwrecks and ruins fishermen. In mythology, Umibozu is described as a grayish-black cloud-like creature with tentacle-like limbs. Another legend says that if Umibozu is angry, he demands that the ship's crew roll a barrel onto the deck, and he in turn fills it with seawater and sinks the ship. Please share in the comments which prehistoric monster you found most frightening, and thanks for watching.